So I'm going to cover the basics of Holobuildings within F2. By the end of this tutorial, you should know how to create a basic structure, how to create blueprints, how to load those blueprints, and how to place a Holobuilding onto the F2 map. Please note, this only works on the desktop version of the website. First of all, creating a blueprint versus creating a new building. Basically, if we go straight to creating a new building, this is only really useful for one-off, very simple designs, as there's no option to save. You also can't use the building more than once. Whereas if we do a blueprint, we have the option to save at any point. Just make sure you have a unique name set, or the save button will be grayed out. Creating via blueprint also allows you to place the building on as many properties as you like. If you plan on selling any buildings when this feature becomes available, this will also likely be done via blueprints. So let's begin. You want to start by clicking the Create a New Blueprint or the Create a New Building button. For this example, I'm going for the blueprint because of the previously mentioned benefits. But the building process will be the same regardless of choice. You will then be presented with a select your property form. You simply start typing in this and it will display available properties relating to what you type in. With this being a blueprint, it does help if you select the property you want to build on, but it's not essential. Just ensure you use a property of the same size or smaller to ensure your building will not only fit on the property you want it to, but it will remain within the maximum number of vertices for the plot. Vertices being corners, as these do change depending on the size of the property. First of all, you want to give your property a name, not only so you know what it is, but so it allows you to use the save function. Now, the most basic of the tools is the rectangle tool, the third tool down in the right corner, the square with a square in each corner. This can be used for making boxes and cubes. It's the easiest to use and will likely become your best friend when creating Holobuildings. You want to left click it and bring your mouse over to the tiles, then click and drag your mouse to increase size. Once you're happy, simply left click again and the object will appear. If you've made a mistake, you can simply use the back button in the bottom right or the keyboard shortcut of CTRL and Z. Now, to get a better look at the object, you might want to move into 3D view. This gives you a much better understanding of height and depth. Do this by clicking the three arrows icon in the top left. This will tilt the camera down. You can move the camera by clicking the left mouse button and dragging forwards and backwards. To pan around the object, you simply hold down CTRL and the left mouse button, then move the mouse and the camera will change position. To exit 3D view, you simply click the same icon. Now, if you want to change the height of the structure, you simply type in the right hand side under the height value. If you notice, this also changes both the estimated cost and estimated volume. It was previously mentioned on the E2 website that the optimum volume for a hollow building is 1000 meters cubed, which is roughly $1. However, that's since been removed, so your guess is as good as mine. Now, if you're happy with your building, you want to come over and click Save Blueprint. Once it's finished saving, you can then hit Close Blueprint. Now, switch over to the My Buildings section by clicking the Buildings icon in the top right and come down to Create a New Building. Clicking this will show the same selection box as before. Here, you want to find the actual property you want to place the blueprint on. Once you've selected the property, come to the top right and click the Add Blueprint icon. This will again bring up a search. Here, you want to search for whatever you named your blueprint earlier on. Once you've picked it, click Select Blueprint and left click within the property to place it. If it's not exactly where you want it, simply click on the building and you can drag it around. Once you're happy with the position, simply click Place Building button in the bottom right. If this is grayed out, you will need to give your building a unique name. and you will then have a screen load showing you the total cost and volume. This can take a little while to finish loading, so don't panic. It will then have a place for however much button. Clicking this will remove that amount from your E2 balance and place the Holo building onto the E2 map. Now that you're comfortable with the basics, why not see what you can do with multiple shapes or even utilizing the other tools in the editor. If you would like to see a part 2 on how to build something more complicated, please let me know in the comments below. As always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I hope this tutorial has been of some help. Have an amazing day.